Everyone, so I've decided to make daily videos of my first year being 30, which starts today because it's my birthday. So the whole point of me actually doing this is because I've had such a crap few months and I've got a 3-year-old little girl. I think it'd be nice for her to look back on the first year that mummy turned 30. All these things happened, which probably going to be quite boring. But, anyhow. So, just going to give you a bit of an insight on what the hell's been going on in my life. So, today is 1st of May. This time last year, I was getting all excited to go to the Philippines, doing a bit of travelling with my husband Adam and my little girl and my mum, travelling different islands, which was amazing, absolutely amazing. And then came back, I did something really drastic, which was cut all my long hair off. I had like hair right down here and then went for a bob. So chopped all that off, which may not seem extreme, but actually is quite a big deal. So I'm in the process of growing it, and not doing too bad. It'll be long again before I know it. My hair grows pretty quick. So that was that. And then in October, I found a lump on the top of my left breast. Great! So, went to the doctors, they didn't think it was really anything to worry about because at the time I was only 29, had no family history of breast cancer or anything like that, and then ended up finding out on the 2nd of November that it was breast cancer, so it was quite a shock. And before that, we'd already started trying for another baby. And I remember saying to the doctor, should I put that on hold until I find out what this lump is? And was actually told, no, I wouldn't need to because it's highly unlikely to be cancerous. So I found out I have breast cancer. That was just massive, a massive shock. And that's the biggest way I could describe it. Absolutely did not think in a million years that I would end up with breast cancer. Especially when I've got no history of it. But I did, and that was that. Fortunately, I didn't have to have chemotherapy. They did something called a HER2 test, which came back negative. And that determines whether you have this protein in you that stimulates the cancer to grow or something. And I didn't have it, so didn't have to have chemotherapy and have to the surgery. So I didn't have to have a mastectomy, but I did have a lumpectomy. So, and after that, they sent off the sample to America, and that came back that my likelihood of the cancer returning, if it was below 12%, I wouldn't need to have chemotherapy, and it came back at 9%, so that was a miracle. So fortunately, didn't need to have chemotherapy, but in the midst of all this, I ended up finding out that I was pregnant. So, so the plan was have a mastectomy, because to have a lumpectomy would have had to have radiotherapy, and you can't have that when you're pregnant. So the plan was, okay, well, you're pregnant, it's not the end of the world, have you You'll have to have a mastectomy, but after the baby's born, can have reconstructive surgery. So that was great. And during this, nobody knew anything about this. We just kept it completely quiet because I didn't want people fussing about me or anything like that. So I just decided to keep it quiet, live life, you know, as if nothing was going on. So the plan was, when I would turn around 3 months pregnant, that I would break the news that, like, oh, I've got breast cancer, but don't worry, it's, you know, it's not that bad, and I'm pregnant! That was the plan. Unfortunately, it didn't turn out that way because I ended up having an ectopic pregnancy, which was really, really heartbreaking because, you know, having the breast cancer and everything, that was pretty crap. But I had something to focus towards, and it was the thought of having another baby, and that was taken away. So, been a bit crappy. And then, just when I thought everything was great, going to plan, you know, we were getting over losing the baby, the breast cancer was turning out to be not as hard as what I thought it was going to be. My dad, who I'm very, very close to, gets taken to hospital, nearly dies. That's not me being dramatic. I don't know why I've got a pen. That's not me being dramatic. He genuinely, like, nearly died, where we were told on a couple of occasions, expect the worst, and they were going to give him 48 to 72 hours to see how he recovers, or they were going to stop all treatment. So, and I was literally coming back from radiotherapy from one hospital and then going to another hospital to sit with my dad, and it was just really hard. So fortunately, everything actually turned out to be not as bad with my dad, and he recovered really well because he's a tough cookie. But then my uncle passed away, who I was also close to, and then my dad's hut that he has at the back of his house got broken into. Wow, this is really depressing. Anyway, apart from all that, everything went really crap, but I just thought, okay, so today I'm 30, let's start on a high. What the hell can go wrong? Nothing, surely. Stay positive. That's what I'm trying to convince myself. So because I've known how things can change in such a short period of time, I want to sort of start making a video diary. And, you know, there's going to be good days, there's going to be crap days. When I'm feeling like crap, I can look back and watch videos of me talking utter rubbish about something good or whatever. But not that I would watch anything bad if I was feeling happy though. So that's why. So today, I got some very nice presents off my husband Adam, some beautiful flowers, got a new iPad, which I'm testing out right now, and what else did I get? Money, perfume, just lots of nice little things. And then I went up to go and see my dad at the hospital. And I came home, got my little girl from nursery, and then we went out for something to eat, which was really nice. And then my friend Catherine came round with a present, and that was really good. And that's what I've done today on my actual birthday. I am having a party in 2 weeks, which I'm really looking forward to. Oh, that has been just, that can't come soon enough. But that's all that's happened today, and here I am making this video. any of you are even remotely interested in watching this, I will be so surprised. But if you are, thanks. Thanks for even being bothered to watch me waffle on. Okay, so I'll see what tomorrow brings.